Everybody, Dr. Cranky here in the laboratory sometime during the middle of the week. We are really pleased with the results so far that we're getting on the Death Stalker, and we just wanted to chime in and talk a little bit about the techniques and the things that you learn along the way, and your bag of tricks. We all have them, and these are things that the more time you put into it, the more diverse a skill set and techniques that you will acquire. It doesn't happen overnight. If you ask any of the builders in the community and beyond how long they've been at it, they will tell you most people have been at it for years, and it's part of the journey. You wanna learn, and you want to have a good time. By the same token, you want to get good results. Now, one of the things that we take pride in here in the laboratory is that we, as we said before, we research, we learn, we look up stuff in magazines, and we learn that way. We read up every chance we get. We see tutorials, we watch tutorials. Even tutorials that involve, real life subject matter. So we're always learning, and that's part of the fun of the process. One of the things that I wanted to tell you, though, to keep in mind is that there are many, many different kinds of techniques, and then there are different kinds of results. So no one technique is going to land you with the perfect, with the perfect result. Sometimes you have to try a variety of things, and we have here in the laboratory. We like to try out new techniques every chance we get and take different approaches, in part because, to be quite honest with you, it's what keeps us from getting bored out of our gourd. Oh, we rhymed. For example, we started out, the very first technique that we started out with was dry brushing. And, like everybody, you try it and you go, okay, that's cool, but, I want to move on to other things. So along came salting and the hairspray technique, a whole bunch of techniques that we've picked up along the way. And so we keep them in our bag of tricks, and we can keep coming back to them. And just know that no one technique is going to see you through your entire journey as a model builder / diorama builder. So keep that in mind, and it'll keep you enthused, it'll keep you energized, it'll keep you going. There are no absolutes. Sometimes you try a technique and it doesn't work, or you don't like it, and then you give up on it, and then, you rediscover it and fall in love with it, and then it works all of a sudden. The more that you try a technique, the better at it you get. And so the challenge for us here is always to get better at using one particular technique. And then once we feel like we've mastered it, then we know that it's always there. This is the truth about using the airbrush. We rely so much on the airbrush these days to do a whole variety of things. So it's part of the joy and the pleasure that we get here in the laboratory. But anyway, keep that in mind so that you don't get frustrated. Have a go at a new technique and learn it. If you don't know how to use an airbrush, we have a bunch of videos in the archives about getting over your fear of using the airbrush. Or if you've never tried something as simple as dry brushing, try it out. As we're dealing with recently, applying pin washes. And, it's just fun. And So let us know. Let us know if you have any questions. We are moving on with this build, and we're having fun, which is what, you know, it's all about, and it's all that matters to us here in the laboratory. All right, my friends, be well, keep doing good work, and stay tuned in. More Cranky Show coming your way before you can ask.